Welcome back to our channel, guys. Today, we have a deck check for Pestilence Contender. Ito yung version 1. Before the set 4 come out, we will review my deck for Pestilence Prince of Plague. Okay, stay tuned. Okay guys, here we go. My deck list for Pestilence, okay. First, we will arrange first. Okay? My pins for my Funko Pop, okay. And syempre, of course, kagad, no? May ginawa ko to ng coaster, okay. So, let's put him there. Okay, this is my support card for my Pestilence. So, I put 4 of the Impictus. You know naman, no? This card is very useful for Pestilence. Because Pestilence only have 0 attack and 1 defense, so this is a very good buff for him. At alam nyo naman na ito pang Harbinger. And this buff, I like about this buff is it give +3/+0 to a target contender or clash card. So even I can buff Pestilence, my contender, and my other clash. I can use either to my contender or to my target clash card. No? And this card also has a discard ability. So this is very useful at very irritating to your opponent if you use this buff. So I always tend to attack Pestilence, no? And then I buff him to discard one of the card of my opponent. So for me, isa sa pinang malakas na buff, this is a powerful buff na ginawa set to, no? And I always make sure when my first draw always have this buff, okay? Second, sorry my voice, medyo don't know, para may plan niya ta tayo, no? And this Pestilence, by the way, is a red green. I don't put blue because it's very tight for me when I experiment it, no? I previously put a lean and bountiful haven bound the haven the bountiful collector, but the synergy doesn't work, no? So I made it, I think, ano na to, mga 6 or 7 revision ko na, no? And nilagay ko yung, ginawa ko na siyang 2 colors, which is green and red. And I put some 4 solar smash. It is very good for me because, for me, it is a very powerful card. You can deal damage directly, 3 damage to target contender or clash card. It can kill some clash card, no? And then I will tap, I will engage Pestilence to draw card. So I kill a clash, I deal damage, and I eliminate some clash card, and I can draw because of the ability of Pestilence. When a clash card opponent controls defeated during the primary phase, I draw a card. This is power, no? And of course for control, I put 2 Here Comes the Boom, especially if I cannot control anymore the board and there's so many class card of the opponent control. So this is my answer to that situation, no? 5 damage to all class card, okay. And then I put a 3 Crimson Scales, no? Because its power also can kill a 1 or 2 health clash card with 1 or 2 health of a clash card. And then I can draw, of course, with Crimson Scale, and also I can draw with Pestilence. So double draw if you ask me why I put this is a very good draw engine from a Pestilence. Okay. This is a very useful and flexible card, a relic for me. Na I can kill one or two class card, and if there's only one I can kill, I can draw, and either I'll use the ability, the second ability, Crimson Scale, to kill or to eliminate a class card. I can tap Pestilence to draw again card. Okay, and then one of my defense, my favorite defense, is this Dreadful Dissemination. As you all know, Pestilence are Avenger, and the ability of this, it's 6, the casting cost 6, but the ability of this trap card of Dreadful Dissemination is whenever I have a Harbinger in my Oblivion, it less 1 green cost. So maybe in mid game or 4 or 5 turns, my 4 to 5 turns, I can cast this for 2 of any color. Okay, so this is my defense, especially if my opponent has a very large class card. Okay, very powerful. I love this card. Okay, and my class ground. Okay, I put 2 wasteland. To utilize my class, especially Pestilence, I can the -2/-2. It's a big deal, and if there's a wasteland, I can make it for I can make it -4/-4, because I can return a class card with 4 or less to my hand, and all my Harbinger got +0/+1. Okay, so this is very synergy to my deck, especially all almost all of my class cards are Harbinger. Okay, and then I put this Amazon Rainforest to eliminate some a very deck that is very reliable to class grounds. So this is my elimination. It will help my Dreadful Dissemination to get more Harbinger to my Oblivion, because this card, when it comes, I can draw, and then during me and my opponent's turn, we able to draw card and discard one. So I will eliminate, I will discard a Harbinger to my hand to make these disseminations very favorable to my Triple Dissemination. Okay, and then my clash, I put Magnate the Tyrant. Very good. I use this as defender, and when it defeated, I get to draw a card. Okay, because my deck is very reliable with draw, so I need many draw as much as possible. Okay, and I put Force, one of the strongest piece in my deck. This is the Pestilence Infectious. Very good for critical elimination for 1 casting cost. Okay, so I get four of them. I put 4 of them, and I put also 4 of Pestilence Mayhem. For me, this is also good. It's good as Pestilence Infectious, because it gave me another draw card, and it can give -1/-1 to target class card or to tender. Okay, so sometimes this is my answer to mirror match, because I cannot damage with 1 defense, or in this case to Heaven or Krung, so I can throw the -1/-1 to the contender, and I can attack my clash. So it's very big deal that I will reduce the defense of my contender. Okay, so of course -1/-1 also incorporate with the ability of Pestilence to draw me another card. So if this card defeated a or kills or eliminate a let's say a token or let's say a 2-1 class card, I get double draw because when it enters to play, I draw a card and then I use again the ability of Pestilence my contender, then I draw again a card. Okay, and of course because of this is red green, I put a War, the second horseman. Okay, this is very good, especially when a wasteland is in the game. No, I can cast this War. When it enters, it make 3 damage to target class card or contender. So if there's a class card, I can kill with War, and then I will tap to draw, and then when it is in the game and it's attack, and the opponent does not eliminate my War, I can return it to my hand, and the next turn, or if my resource can able to pay him again, I can cast him again to deal again 3 damage and to attack again. Okay, so this way is very useful, especially with my Harbinger deck. And since this is a Harbinger also, and if it dies, it also contribute to my Dreadful Dissemination. Okay, and then of course this War Stripe Bringer, this is my little damage to my opponent because it came, it create a token, and then I'll attack it with Breakthrough, and I pump the token, and I will use my buff. So overall damage of one attack of this, if there's no blocker or obstruct, it will damage around 8. If there's no obstruct, of course anything he obstruct we will defeat it, and we will have breakthrough, especially if I use this buff. Okay, and it's only 4 casting cost. Yeah, casting cost. And one of my favorite card drawer, of course, I put 4 Pestilence DB Servant. Okay, this is a very powerful card because it, when your hand is only 3 and it's attack, I can draw additional card, and its power become the number of my hand. So if there's only 3 and 3 in my hand, and I attack this one, so I'll draw another card, so it get 4 very, very good for an engine, especially for a card drawer like my contender Pestilence. And if ever I have too many cards, I have 7 cards in my end of turn, another class card, I can able to ready again. So for me, this is a very powerful card also. Okay, and one of my best creature elimination, of course, Pestilence, the Plague Bringer. Okay, -3/-3, 3/3 for the cast. So definitely I can use again him to draw a card with my Pestilence, with my contender Pestilence. So -3/-3, very good. It's a very good card controller, especially with opponent has a class card that let's say 3 health and below. And of course, because of there's so many relic and traps, okay, so I put Magnet the Tyrant. Okay, I put also only 2, but in my sideboard I think I have 2 also of this Tyrant. If my opponent has so many traps, relic or weapons, I put another 2 for me to eliminate those trap cards that I don't want, no, and to give advantage to my side. And and of course I put 4 Kagan. Okay, OG, alam niyo naman ginagawa ni Kagan, and you know what Kagan does. So this is sometimes my finisher, my what you call this, game ender. Okay, I put 4. Okay, and for my sideboard, that is my main board, and my sideboard I put 2 Tyrant, okay, and I put 2 Magnet ready for battle, because I love this. What I love this card is this is 2/4 and for only 3 tokens, and if ever now it get victory, I can take a look at the top of my tomato of my deck, and if I get a non-clash buff, no, actually non-clash buff, I can put that into my hand. Okay, non-clash, and I can put it into my hand, or if not, I can put that on the bottom of my deck. Now, if the clash card that I don't need is in the top of my deck, I can put it at the bottom so I can draw again. Okay, and I put Defile Place. I love this card because it trigger again target clash card effect, enter effect. Okay, even in my opponent's control, I can trigger that again in my favor, and all clash card get -1/-0. So a very powerful card control controller. This is a clash card. Okay, so again, if my opponent is especially in case of Chrome, too many clash card that is what you call a small clash card that only, let's say, two attack power. If this is in the field, and of course you know that my contender is -0/-0/0/1, so two attack power cannot be my contender cannot be damaged, because -1 and then plus the defense upon pestilence, they cannot damage me. Okay, and then I put 1 magnet trap. And this is for special. This card is designed for Krung, no? Pang kontra, we can say it. This is very good for to what you call this, yung panlaban or against Krung deck. Okay, this barb countermeasure, because lot of when set 3 is released, there's so many Krung user in the Philippines, so I put this card as a sideboard, and it's very very useful versus to Krung deck. Okay, so that is my sideboard, and that is my deck list or deck tech for my Pestilence. Okay, I hope I can use him after set for release, because there's a lot of new cards, but for a Pestilence version too. I don't think that they have a good card to combo with Pestilence version 1, this one. Okay, and I hope I can use this Pestilence contender again or my deck in set 4, but I doubt it. No? It's very all the spoiler that been released is for the proper Pestilence, is for Pestilence version 2. Well, maybe. Let's see. Tinatang na mangyayari. Okay? So, yun lang muna, guys. Thank you very much. And please, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Okay? Thank you very much. God bless. Nick Nock here, saying always stay safe and happy hunting to all. Bye! Grabe. Nosebleed na naman ako.